Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be creating this makeup look using mainly Primark makeup, which I've never used before. Obviously, if you're from the UK, you will know Primark is a very affordable, mainly clothing store, but they kind of just do a bit of everything now, don't they? And they've got all their makeup. They've now brought out skincare as well. And I'm contemplating the skincare, but I just thought I'd pick up makeup for today. So I picked up pretty much everything for a whole makeup look. There are a few little hiccups along the way, but you'll see that soon. And yeah, I'm testing them out in this video. So if you want to see how I created this look and what I think of the makeup, then please keep watching. Now, obviously with Primark makeup, it is obviously quite cheap makeup, like quite affordable makeup, not necessarily the cheapest because some things are quite pricey. But with cheaper products, I'm always a little bit concerned that that the quality isn't as good, and if it's actually as good for your skin. I know that obviously you can definitely buy really good products for your skin at low prices. Like, there's some of the ingredients are not expensive at all to get a good skincare routine, a good makeup routine. But I'm just a little bit cautious sometimes when something's like super, super cheap and I'm gonna be putting it on my face. I'm just a little bit, But I thought we'd try it anyway and see what I thought of them. So yeah, without further ado, don't forget to give the video a like if you enjoy it and hit subscribe and let's dive into it. Okay, so these are all the makeup products in here. And I've got quite a lot, so let's go through them first. I feel like this camera's too high. Let me just move it. Okay, so I managed to pick up most things to do like a whole makeup look, apart from foundation. I think that's it. So I'm gonna show you exactly what I got and then I'm gonna do my makeup. So I wanted some beauty blenders. I wanted those little like powder puffs, you know, the little triangular ones that are everywhere. And I actually saw someone on TikTok with the Primark ones, but I couldn't find them. But I did manage to find these. How cute are these? Little Bratz beauty blenders. We've got a mascara, which looks like an absolute dupe of Better Than Sex, which I absolutely love, so I thought I would try that one out. I picked up a brow pencil. They only had this in brown or blonde. So I went for brown, but it might be a bit too dark. I got a lip kit in the shade Lust. Picked up a little kabuki brush. This isn't makeup, but I picked up some of these little microfiber cloths because I use these, well, every day, so just thought I'd pick those up. I got a gel eyeliner. Now, I got two eyeshadow palettes, which I'm quite excited to try. So I got one called Fiery and one called Exposed. So this is what the outsides look like. So the Fiery one, those are the shades there. Obviously, it's got the plastic on, so I'll show you more in a bit. And then the Exposed one looks like this. So yeah, I thought they looked really nice. I picked up some loose baking powder. I got a cream bronzer, a cream blush, and finally a concealer. So I've pretty much got a whole makeup look. Obviously, I haven't got primer. I didn't get a foundation because the foundation stand was just an absolute mess. It was literally foundation everywhere, like actual liquid everywhere. So it literally looked like someone had just gone in and poured it everywhere. And it was quite busy there, so I just thought, right, I'm just not even going to bother with that. So yeah, so let's dive into it then. For a primer, I'm just going to be using the MAC Fix Plus Prep and Prime. And then for the foundation, I'm going to use the Kabuki brush. So this is the Kabuki brush. This was £2. And it looks really soft. Obviously, I've not tried it yet. That's quite soft, actually. That feels pretty nice. So this is what it looks like. It says Kabuki brush there on the bottom. It has a bit of glue left over on the bottom, which is a little bit sticky, but I can't really get that off. But yeah, it feels really, really nice. So for foundation, I'm actually going to use the Misguided foundation because I've been enjoying that recently. So this is the Meet Your Match foundation in the shade 3. So that's what it looks like. So I'm just going to apply it with the Kabuki brush. I'm just going to go straight in onto my hand.
Magnificent.
Now this does feel like quite flexible. More so than the other Kabuki brushes. Maybe it'd be more suited for like a blush or like a powder brush, but... so it looks like it's blended it quite nice. It does feel quite soft. It did lose a hair on the way, so a hair did end up on my cheek, but that's fine. But yeah, not bad. Okay, next let's try the concealer. So the concealer is the Liquid Concealer Medium Coverage, and it was £2, and I got the shade Cool Sand. Now, it was quite hard to tell the shade because the ones that were there all looked the same, and there weren't really many to choose from. And like I said before, it was really, really busy, so I literally just reached and grabbed this one. because I thought this one looked okay. So it might be the wrong colour, but okay. Yeah, so liquid concealer. Okay, it says it's got aloe vera and vitamin E in, so sounds nice. So this is what it looks like. There's quite a lot of product on the one, that's quite nice. Quite a lot comes out with it. Bit of a weird smell to it. Okay, now I'm actually going to use a beauty blender to blend that. I should have opened those first. So these are the beauty blenders I'm going to be using. So cute. These were £3, it says it on the front. Okay, it feels quite hard. It's not as squishy as some. This is what it looks like. So I'm just going to dampen it with the MAC Fix Plus. Okay, so for under the eyes, I'm actually going to use this little brush. This is a Zoeva brush. And just blend that out with this brush. It says medium coverage, but I feel like it is quite thick. Okay, so that's the concealer done. Now we're gonna go in with the cream blush. So this is the cream blush. I got the shade Rose. This was £3.50. They did have another shade, which was, I think, Peach. So it has a little mirror inside, which is quite cute. And this is the shade, so it looks like quite creamy. So I'm going to use this Real Techniques 444 Filtered Cheek Brush. So I'm just going to dab a little bit and get it on my brush. Oh, it doesn't really want to go on the brush. Okay, you really have to work the brush into the cream. I've got some on my brush, so I'm just going to go in here like this. That's quite a concentrated colour, isn't it? Quite pigmented. Okay. Try and blend that out a little bit. That's actually quite nice once it's blended. Yeah, I think that's nice. Let's do the other side. So I have the cream blush, quite nice. Next up, we're going to use the cream bronzer. So this is the cream bronzer, it's the Bronze Whip and it was £4.50. So this is what it looks like. Okay, we're not going to use this one because it's actually already been used. Ew. This was from the back as well. Yeah, it's definitely already been used, I'm not going to be using that. Velvet Finish Whipped Cream Bronzer it's called. £4.50 as well. Well, that's annoying. Okay, instead then, let's use the Clinique Chubby Stick. So I'm just going to dab a little bit here. And same on the other side. I'm just going to blend that first. So I'm going to use... So I'm just going to use a little spectrum brush to blend this out. Taking the excess underneath my jawbone. So I'm just going to actually apply it with a brush now. Just apply a little bit more on this side just to make it match. And then we're also going to go up here as well. So I'm just going to use it. Apply it with a brush. And then I'm also just going to do a little bit down my nose as well. Okay. Clinique is always reliable. Next we're going to go in with the loose baking powder. This one's all sealed up, so it's definitely not been opened, so that's what it looks like. As you take the lid off, this is what you see. So it is all sealed up as well with a sticker, which is nice. So I'm just going to tap a little bit into the lid. Now it does say translucent, but it's definitely got a bit of a colour to it. So I'm going to use the other beauty blender now, the other Bratz blender. So I've just applied that with the blender, went on quite nicely, and then I'm not going to wait around for it to set, I'm literally just going to blend it in. Yeah, I actually really like that, I think that's gone really, really nicely. So I'm just going to tap the excess back into the tub. Now I didn't get any powder, blush or bronzer, so I'm just going to use, the bronzer I'm going to use is the Beauty Crop Bronzer. So I'm just going to apply it with my bronzer brush. This is my trusty Spectrum Collections brush, and I'm just going to use the top one here, the kind of lightest one. I got this palette in a mystery box and it's actually really nice. Like, I was really impressed with it. I didn't expect to be, I don't know why. And then for the blush, I'm actually going to use my Misguided Stop and Blushing powder with the Luxie Blusher Brush. And there we have the base done. I quite like that. Okay, next we're going to do brows. So for brows, I got this pencil. So it's the Brow Sketch Brow Pencil. It's got a spoolie at one end, pencil at the other, and it was £2. £2. This is what it looks like. I'm just going to take the cellophane off. None of the packaging actually has that, like, you know, the perforated bit that just peels off, so it's so difficult to get off. Okay, so I managed to get half of the packaging off, but this is just ridiculous. But like, you can still see the packaging in the middle, so I've just ended up pulling off the end. So yeah, on this end we've got a pencil in the shade brown, and we've got a spoolie on the other end. So that is the colour. I reckon it might be a bit dark, but we're just gonna give it a go. So I'm just gonna brush my brows and then fill in with this pencil. So there we go. So that was okay. I had to twist it up a few times throughout. It was okay though. Probably not my favourite brow product, but not bad. Did an alright job. I also didn't pick up a brow gel because that section was very busy and I wasn't going to be battling three people just to get a brow gel. So I'm just going to use my Benefit brow gel as usual. It's the 24 hour brow setter. This is my favourite one. So there we go, so brows are done. Okay, so for eyes then, we've got two different eyeshadow palettes. We've got the mascara, which looks like the Better Than Sex mascara. And we've also got an eyeliner. So I'm gonna do an eyeshadow look first. So the two palettes we've got is the Exposed palette, which looks like this. And then we've also got the Fiery palette, which looks like this. So, I think for today, I'm just going to use the Exposed palette. So let's take this plastic off so you can see the colours. So these are the colours that we're working with. They look like really nice everyday colours for me. I've got some mattes, a couple of shimmers. So yeah, let's see how pigmented they are. That's what I'm intrigued about. So as always, I'll go in with a base, a lighter base, then a bit of colour, then a bit of contour, and maybe a bit of shimmer then in the middle. Well, I'll do the eyeshadow and then I'll tell you what colours I use afterwards. Okay, so quite a lot actually comes out like onto your brush as you're rubbing it in. See that? It's quite a lot of product there. So let's see what it's like. Okay, that's very pigmented. That's actually really nice. It's supposed to be the base colour as well. I like this. Oh my goodness, I did not expect to like this at all. Cute though. Okay, contour then. So I'm gonna use a darker colour. Just the tiniest amount because you don't need a lot. I'm sorry, but look at those colours. How nice. Have they just blended together? Okay. So I'm going to go underneath the eye as well, and I'm just going to use that middle colour, I think. I'm so obsessed. Like, they've blended so nicely. It's so creamy. I love it. Okay, now a bit of a shimmer in the corner then. Let's try it. Okay, I can't actually spot my brush, so I'm just going to use this little brush again. Let's go with this one. This looks cute. I mean, pretty good, isn't it? I mean, this is Primark. How is this Primark? So I'm just gonna blend that out. Magnificent. That is insane. Like, can you see that? Can you see how nice that is? How is Primark? This was £5. £5 for this eyeshadow palette, and this is what you get. Insane. Okay, so next then, I'm going to use the eyeliner. So this is the gel eyeliner with brush, and this was also £2. So this is what this one looks like. So if we can get into this one. Okay, so it's a little pot like this, and it comes with a brush. Oh, it's like an actual brush. Okay, so this is the brush then. And then if we open this, okay, so it's like an actual gel liner. I used to use one of these from MAC years ago, and I haven't used it for the longest time, but let's give it a go. This isn't the brush I'd use either, but it's the one that comes with it, so I'm going to use it. This might go very wrong. This brush just seems too thick for this. We're gonna make it work. It'll work. Okay, that's not too bad. We've made it work. I feel like the brush is just like really, really thick for getting that precise flick. It's not the easiest, but it's okay. Well, that didn't go right, did it? Okay, this one looks like I've done it. This one looks like a child's done it. Okay, I've kind of neatened it up, so it looks a bit better. Might need to thicken this side though now. It's kind of like that meme, isn't it, where you end up looking like a panda. Okay, that will do. That was okay. Would I use that again? No, definitely not. But for £2, it looks all right. Okay, now on to the mascara. Now this packaging looks like the Too Faced Best in Sex mascara, which is, as you probably know, one of my favourite mascaras. The brush doesn't look the same. The before and after looks like quite a big promise. But we will see what it looks like. So, the actual packaging is called False Lash Queen. I'll do one eye and then compare it to the other. 87% said it gives dramatic volume based on 57 women who tried it. Let's try it. So this is the wand. That's what it looks like. Looks okay. Right, let's have a go then. I mean, I'm not really getting false lash vibes here. What do we think? Okay, that looks okay. Not the worst. It's making them look pretty long. So that is the before and after. There we go, mascara is on. Would I say it's a dupe? No. No, I wouldn't. Okay, and then the final step, then we've got some lip product here. So this is the Soft Touch Luster Lipstick and Super Shine Gloss. They also have like a matte liquid lipstick kit, but I thought I would try this one. So the shade is Lust. It's not been opened, which is a good start. So these are the two products here. So I've got the lipstick here in a nice colour. I like this. And then we've got the matching gloss. It looks rather sticky. Okay, I did think they were going to be like darker and more reddish based on this, but no, it's actually pretty spot on. This is a really nice colour. I didn't get a liner, so I'm just going to use MAC Whirl and just use that one. Okay, I normally colour in a little bit from the line as well, but I want to give this lipstick as much space as possible. Okay, so it's definitely not been used. It smells quite nice. A bit coconutty. Nice and creamy. I like that. That's really nice. And then the gloss on top. I'm gonna pop a layer on top as well. This smells really nice as well. Now we have the lip. That's cute, I like that. And then I'm just gonna set it with the MAC Fix Plus. And then we have a finished makeup look using Primark makeup, mainly. So overall verdict then, I think, let's look at the products. Let's look at the products one by one. Okay, so the first product that I used was the Kabuki brush, and I used it for foundation. I think this would be better used for powder, for loose powder or anything like that. It was nice, soft, yeah, not bad at all. Foundation obviously was the misguided one. The beauty blenders, they're not the softest ones, they're not the squishiest. I prefer the ones I've been using recently. The Fenty one is so squishy, I really like that one. This one's a bit, it's okay, not bad. But yeah, that was okay. The concealer seemed nice, seemed average, it wasn't anything special. Then the cream blush, I actually really like this colour. I think this is such a nice shade. It blended nicely. And I feel like that just looks really nice on my base. Obviously the cream bronzer could not give you a verdict on because somebody had used it, which is ugh. The powder, really good. So it says translucent, it doesn't look translucent, but I feel like it set my base really nicely, so I did really like that one. Then moving on to the eyes. Now this eyeshadow palette, I'm so impressed with. Look at my eyeshadow. Look at the glow as well from the highlight. So for my eyeshadow, I used this top colour here as the base. I then went in with this darker one over the base. I used this one for my contour and then this one for the highlight, which I used here and also on my brow bottom. And yeah, that was so nice. It felt so creamy. They were very pigmented and they blended really, really nicely. So for £5, you can't go wrong. So I got that one. I didn't try this one today, but I can try this one another time. And they also had a couple more. They had some smaller palettes. I think they had some quads. And they had another one that was this size as well, but I just thought two will do for now. So yeah, I really recommend those. I think they're really nice. The eyebrow pencil, nothing special, and it took me literally 20 minutes to open it from the packaging, which is not ideal. And then moving on to the eyeliner, it was actually fairly difficult to apply because the brush isn't the right brush. For me, the brush I kind of like to use with gel liner is something like this. You know, it's like a very fine pointed one, like a very fine angled brush, not the one like this. So I feel like it didn't go too well. It wasn't bad, but no. For £2, you know, you get what you pay for. And then next, the mascara. Whilst the packaging looks like Too Faced, it definitely didn't feel like Too Faced. And I mean, obviously £3.50 compared to however much Too Faced is, I can't remember, £25. Yeah, I don't feel like I got an instant false lash. I didn't feel like I got an instant false lash effect from using it. And I feel like I had to do two layers as well, which I don't have time to do. I always just do one layer. I'm a one layer of mascara kind of girl. So yeah, nothing special really. But then the lip products, I feel like this was really, really nice. The lipstick is a really nice colour. They both smell like holiday. A bit coconutty. Yeah, really nice, creamy application. And yeah, I feel like it's a nice finish. I should have got a liner with it though as well, but I didn't. But yeah, overall, those are my verdicts on the Primark Beauty makeup. So there we go, so that is the finished look. Yeah, some of the products not bad, I would buy again. Some of them definitely not. So yeah, let me know what you think of this look, let me know what you think of the products, and if you've tried any of these products as well, let me know in the comments down below. And yeah, if you did enjoy it, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. If there's any other makeup brands you want me to try that I've not tried before and I can do a full makeup look with it, then please let me know that as well. But other than that, click the bell to be notified next time I post a video, and I'll see you soon for another video.